Generally, the mineral ion concentration inside the cell can be higher than the surrounding soil. In this case, the ions move against the concentration gradient. That is, from lower concentration to higher concentration. This movement is termed as active transport and requires energy. Two theories, carrier concept theory and electrochemical gradient theory, have been proposed to explain how ions are taken up by plants via active absorption. Carrier concept theory. According to the carrier concept, the movement of ions across a membrane is mediated by special carrier molecules present in the membrane. These carrier molecules are usually proteins, but they can also be cytochromes and lesser thin phospholipids. Generally, carrier molecule works by binding ions to the carrier molecule and forms a carrier ion complex, causing a change in the conformation of the carrier molecule. The carrier ion complex passes through the membrane. When it reaches the inner side of the membrane, the carrier molecule changes its conformation and releases the ion. After the release of the ion, the carrier moves back to the outer surface of the membrane to bind another ion. The binding of ion and its release both require energy, which is provided by ATP. Electrochemical gradient hypothesis. An electrochemical gradient exists across the plasma membrane of the cells. This is due to two things. 1. The splitting of water molecules into hydrogen and hydroxyl ions. 2. The conversion of ATP into ADP and PI, inorganic phosphate. The proton pumps, in plasma membrane, pump out hydrogen ions while hydroxyl ions stay inside the cell, giving inside of the cell a negative charge. The proton concentration increases outside the cell than inside, generating a proton motive force. The electrical and proton gradients established as a result drive cation and anion uptake. Anions from outside the cell are exchanged with hydroxyl ions inside the cell, while the cations move inside the cell via ATPase. ATPase configuration changes as it binds the cation. It then transports the cation into the cell and changes back its configuration to bind another cation. This process is aided by the hydrolysis of ATP.